Shine Runners Racing Radio Show is dedicated to the fans, drivers, promoters, and most importantly, the families of local auto racing. Our mission and commitment is to help build, promote, and support the local tracks across the country.
Stay tuned. You're watching Shine Runners Racing Radio. Hey, y'all happen to see the revenue.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Shine Runners Racing Radio. I'm your host, the Rooster, in the house with you. And, man, we have got a packed house for this week. Hollywood AJ Bellinger riding along with us. Man, what do you think about all this?
Man, this is crazy. I tell you what, I am just as nervous on this show as I was the very first show.
Well, this is a big show, man, and we've got some great guests in the house tonight. Along with our crew, we've got Racin Ryan in the house with us.
Absolutely.
You know, we got Jay Swan, the Sasquatch of Boone City, and that man's ready to rock and roll. We're going to talk a little bit about that. He's pumped, son, pumped. Jim the Magic Man in the house with us, Jim the Magic Man Lewis, Miss Angie, and Shandy, our beautiful Shine Girls here in the house, as well as Raging Rooster. They're outside, man, doing it big.
And how about the fire department coming over? First thing they said, we've been waiting on this trailer to get here all day. 50 wings.
50 wings.
Straight out.
To start with.
Yeah.
You know, and if you come by tonight, you don't have to stay and watch the show if you don't want to. But if you want to stay and watch the show, you're more than welcome to. Come in the back door.
Yeah.
That's how we do it. This
yeah.
is a speakeasy. You know what I'm saying? Three knocks and a then we'll let you in.
And a brown bag.
Brown bag, yeah. But, you know, if you come by tonight and you purchase anything, a piece of corn, you purchase a drink, you purchase 10 wing plate, what do you get a chance of?
You're going to get entered. You're going to get a ticket. You're going to take it over there, put it in the tumbler, and you're going to get entered to win two free tickets to tomorrow's Wayne Gray Senior Memorial Lucas Oil Dirt Race.
And
Boone
that's
City.
Why Swanee's pumped up.
Oh,
man.
Yeah.
He's ready. I'm talking
I see the excitement on his face.
$10,000
yep.
on the line for tomorrow night. Man, it's going to be exciting. But you know what? Let's roll on with the show. We got a lot of exciting things coming in tonight. We've got Robbie Draughon from Draughon Powertrain Development, and he's been pumping out a lot of horsepower here in the racing around the area. We got Brian Ivey in the house, mm-hmm. all the way down from the rattlesnake baby in the snake pit. He's going to be coming talking to us about you know, all kinds of stuff they got going on and the Carolina Sprints that's rocking down there this weekend. And you know what? We have got the number 88 driver. Johnson and Hardee Enterprises, the Super Street Mac Daddy, Old Dirty himself.
Is he still dirty?
Still dirty and old dirty. We're going to find out about that. But we got Daniel Johnson to be coming in here shortly, y'all. So tell you what, we're going to go ahead and throw a caution flag. We're going to get some, go to see some of our special, you know, advertisers that are doing it. And then
Absolutely.
We're going to come back with Robbie Draughon from Draughon Powertrain Development.
We'll be back after these commercials.
I'm Bill W. with Rockview Speedway.
I'm Charlie Castle, race director, favorite motor speedway.
I'm Thomas, driver in the 50 Mile Life.
Hi, I'm Ben McCall, driver of the number 7 Austin Sprint.
This is my son, Brody Callahan, driver of the junior dragster Black Ops Paintball, and we're watching Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Hey, I'm Ashton Jackson, and you're watching Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Looking to ease the pain of cooking for your guests? Tired of hosting the party but staying on the grill all night? Let us help you. Raging Rooster, a fully functional rolling kitchen loaded with the official chicken wings of Shine Runners Racing Radio. Owned and operated by Tony and Bobby Jackson. Contact them at 910-237-4565 or jackson.bobby@yahoo.com. Raging Rooster Wings, come get you some.
Don't gamble with your plumbing. Let 1-800-PLUMBING deal you the winning hand every time. Our trained professionals have the knowledge it takes to turn any full house into a flush. Fully licensed and insured with over 70 years of experience, the staff of 1-800-PLUMBING is here 24 hours a day to show your queen you're the king of the castle. It's as easy as dialing 1-800-PLUMBING. That's 1-800-758-6246 when you need it done right.
Throwing the green flag on, and look at who we have got in here, ladies and gentlemen, the doctor of downright fast, Robbie Draughon.
He is, man. It's great to have you here. You've been, I think, Magic Man said it earlier, he's been to like every show
that we've had, I think, so far.
Yeah.
We got fans. But we got a lot of fans of yours and fans of your horsepower, man. How's it going?
It's going good.
Good deal.
Good to be here.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about your years of racing and, you know, what got you into the part of getting out, not necessarily just getting out of the seat, because I know you still race, but more so leaning towards the building part of it.
Well, I've been around racing one way or another basically my whole life. I raced go-karts when I was a kid, and my dad drag raced, and you know, I've drag raced since I was 16 years old, and basically I started building engines because I couldn't afford to have any of the big-name engine builders build my own stuff, so that's how I got into it.
You know, and you had one of the wildest-looking angler panels deals I've seen in a long time, man. Is that car still around, or what are you racing now?
We sold that car about a year ago. It went to Bakersfield, California. We've got a 66 Corvette now, NHRA Superstock car.
Oh, cool. You know, and now you also have, along with Robbie Draughon, Powertrain Development, you guys also have the Redline Speed Shop, you know, where you sell products and all that stuff as well.
Yeah, basically I do all the machine work and engine building, and Tabitha orders the parts and sells the parts, and we kind of tag team it.
That's cool. You know, we talked to her earlier, and we'll go ahead and reemphasize for those folks that may not have watched the last episode that Tabitha was on. You can go to Redline Speed Shop, buy the parts, come to you, put it together.
Yeah. She sells anything you can think of that's racing related, and we can build basically anything racing related at the shop.
You know, and we had a chance to talk a little bit earlier, and we were talking about all that you do as far as motor building, and you said you have three specifics that you really get into as far as motor building.
Yeah, any kind of race engine. I mean, we do things from 360 sprints to ASCS stuff to limited late models out here at Fayetteville to pure stock and super street, even the U cars. I mean, we do a little bit of all of it, and of course the drag race stuff. And we do a little bit of everything. We do marine engines. I like working on boat stuff, and the classic car, like the restoration engines for classic cars. I enjoy doing those too.
That's cool. You know, I got a son that's going to be going into red plate next year in the clones. You got a little something for that. You know, we want to pass the tech guy though. That's a plus. Passing the tech. You know, we actually got the track owner here tonight, so we don't want to say all the money we're going to put into it. But you know what I mean.
We'll save a little bit of that money so we can slide it to the tech man. You know.
Yeah. You know, as far as go kart engines go, you know, with these new motors, the flat tops have. They still run them, but they don't run them as much as they run these animal engines. You know, what's the prices and all that stuff? The reasoning why?
Well, basically, just technology's done away with the flathead motor. I mean, overhead valve's a lot more efficient. You know, it's just technology's just took it over.
Mm-hmm. So you say you do marine building as well?
Yeah, we actually got pretty much the only engine dyno in the Fayetteville area, and we put boat engines on the engine dyno because you can't put a boat on a chassis dyno.
Yeah.
And run them, and you can tell the kind of horsepower and, you know, make sure you ain't got no problems with it before you put in a boat.
Cool. That's awesome. You know, and while we're online, you know, and we got our folks out there watching, if anybody has any motor questions or anything, please feel free to go ahead and tap in if you have a question or you're having an issue with a motor. You know, while we've got Robbie live in studio, our wonderful Shine Girls over here are taking down your notes, and they're going to be asking them while, you know, we have you in studio. One thing, kind of what we were wondering, what makes horsepower without breaking the bank in half? You know what I'm saying? I know that it costs money to build a high-performance engine, but you got a lot of guys that are going out there to running pure stocks, they're running super streets, and we actually have a gentleman who's coming in a little bit later. I'm sure you're familiar with Old Dirty.
Oh, yeah. And for a long time.
You know, we've seen a lot of his car in pure stock in the winner's circle with that, you know, Robbie Draughon Powertrain Development sticker on the side of it. But what can some of these guys do just getting into racing where it's not breaking the bank, you know what I mean?
Basically, just if you're going to build a motor, build a good bottom end, make it reliable, make it live, get your seat time. That's the big thing. You know, speed will come.
Yeah. So is it more driver than it's motor? Is it? I mean, how does that work?
Well, it's a little bit of everything. You got to have the total package if you want to win.
Yeah. You know, we got coming up, and like we say, ladies and gentlemen, on with us, Robbie Draughon of Draughon Powertrain Development here with us. The Lucas Oil coming up. This coming tomorrow night, as a matter of fact. You know, these guys, super late model drivers, what do you have, you know, an amount of what some of these motors are costing going in these rides?
Yeah, in the $50,000 to $60,000 range for a good super motor.
That's, man, that's impressive. Yeah. You know, I would get, like, I'm over here, you know, grilling Spam right now. So needless to say that I probably need to start, like, U-Car. You know what I mean? Maybe I need to start cutting grass for Jim Long or something.
I don't know. U-Car's pretty tough. You had to deal with Mr. U-Car then.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That guy has been tearing it up lately, man.
Which one is that?
I believe it's Brandon Jacobs, correct?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Brandon. Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. When's the last time has he lost?
I don't think he's lost yet.
Yeah, I seen old Pine Tree out there. You know old Pine Tree number 37. He lost the front tire or something the other day.
Did he get faster?
Yeah. A little bit when the front tire come off of it.
Picked a fine time to leave him loose wheel,
Loose wheel.
Yeah.
No doubt. Robbie, can you tell us a little bit about how folks can get in contact with you as far as, you know, where you're located on the internet, places like that, so we can get them? Because our whole deal is to get people to you. That's what we want to do with Shine Runners Racing Radio, you know?
Yeah, you can visit our website at rdpdengines.com or give us a call at 910-988-2619 or come by the shop, 5222 Clematis Street in Fayetteville.
I believe we got a question coming in. Miss Shandy's got some this is scary. We got questions coming in for you, so brace yourself.
It's a little bit more of a comment. Kyle Freeman was just giving you a good comment. He said that Robbie builds good stuff.
Oh, yeah. We did the engine in Kyle's late model. That was the first Ford engine we'd done. We don't discriminate Ford, Chevy. If you bring it, we'll build it.
Right. You know, and I've had a chance to know you for a while. I mean, I can remember those good nights where it was me and you. We left Tar Heel Racetrack. And I'm going to grab a beer while I'm talking about this. And we were singing Boys to Men. Now, you're a good Boys to Men singer on karaoke. I don't know if you remember that night. Jägermeister had you held down just a little bit.
Yeah. In them days, man, there ain't no telling what you got out of me.
Well, we got to have, you know, you've been drag racing a long time. We got to have one of them good drag racing stories you said you got in your back pocket somewhere.
Oh, man.
I heard something about a monkey the other day.
Well, that ain't one of my stories. That's just some stories I've been told growing up, you know. That's them urban legends.
I don't think you can tell that story.
Yeah, you can't tell that story here. It's not PG.
PG.
Yeah.
Give us something, man. One of your favorite racing moments, something that really stands out, that keeps you not only building motors, but being at the racetrack.
Well, it's kind of two different facets. I mean, really, I used to be more serious about racing. Now I'm more serious about engine building. But I guess the best moment in 2011, we won the Division 9 IHRA Superstock Championship with a stick shift car. And nobody runs a stick shift car anymore. It's kind of a thing of the past, but it's something fun I enjoy doing. And basically, we started out the year and went to the first race, and we went to Fayetteville the night before and run, and we stayed there till 3 in the morning. We had to get up at about 6 and leave and drive 2 hours to Piedmont. We go up there and get down to 3 cars, and, man, I'm so tired. And I sleep on a tree, and I come back, and Tabitha's about to beat me. You know, she said, you could have won the race. You had the best car out here. What happened? I said, I'm tired, boss. And then 2 weeks later, we go to the next race, and that's at Mooresville. And we end up winning that race. And that just kind of set the momentum for the rest of the season. And, you know, we ended up at the end of the year with the most points and won the championship.
So while other folks are trans braking and everything else, you're running a clutch.
Yeah,
you're just in the floorboard, we're just tearing it up.
Dropping the clutch and pulling 4 gears.
Yeah.
Well, what? And now I may have missed this earlier. And if I do it, trust me, the crew's going to let me know about it because
they laugh at me all the time.
Yeah, it would be my turn for a change. But the equipment that you've got in your shop, can you name off some of the stuff? I know we had some pictures earlier of, I think, like a crank grinder and, you know, all that stuff.
Basically, that's what I take pride in. We don't have to farm anything out. We do everything in-house. So if somebody brings their super special secret engine parts over there, nobody else sees them. You know, we do everything in-house. We grind cranks, balance cranks, born home blocks, engine dyno, flow bench, Certi valve equipment. I mean, there's nothing we can't do in-house.
Right. And now that's your crank grinder on the screen right now.
Yep.
And the one before that was, let's see, the engine balancer.
Yeah.
That's for, I would assume, you know, balancing your cranks.
Yeah,
and
you can balance the crank.
Together, rotating assembly.
A lot of people don't know, you actually balance the camshafts, too. It takes harmonics out of the valve train.
Really?
Yeah.
And that's why they pay you the big bucks, man, because I would have no idea what to do with any of that equipment right there.
Man, let's take it down to pit row. I think our Shine Girls actually have another question for Robbie.
All right, Robbie. Terry Odom asked, what is the cost range for a Super Street engine?
I'd say on the low end, probably $6,500. The high end, probably $13,000 to $14,000. Just depends on what you want to do. I mean, you can run an aftermarket block. It's like anything else. You can spend as much as you want to, but I can put somebody, you know, up front for, I'd say, $7,500 to $8,000 and be a good front-running motor.
And is that, like, that's obviously not turkey. That's not going to come with your carburetor and all that stuff, though.
No, that's intake to pan, basically.
Which is pretty much complete.
Pretty much complete. You know, the only thing you really have to come up with is a carburetor and, you know, and you know, we dyno them, and that way they'll know what kind of power they're working with. You know,
and you sell them a carburetor too, right? Because I mean, different engine packages need different carburetors, and of course, you got to work on the jets and what all is going on. That's where your dyno comes.
Oh yeah,
in
that's
where
the dyno,
right?
Comes into play. I mean, basically, you put up there, and it tells you air fuel ratio, and you can have that engine tuned in. You know, you ain't got no leaks, no problems. It's perfect when you put it in the car.
Awesome.
You know, I just seen on here, was kind of tapping in, some folks had wrote in. Miss Lisa Johnson said that you had put one of them power plants in Jerry Johnson's car.
Oh, yeah, Jerry's.
Man, Jerry's been doing real good this year. You know, Jerry had a tough year last year. You know, but Jerry showed a lot of people that keep your heart, keep your head in the game. You know, Jerry ran up. They diagnosed him with cancer and had a tough little time, but you know, even before he was fully cured, he was back in that race car and out there doing it, man. And it showed to what type of driver. I mean, he's straight up to championship status this year so far.
Oh, yeah. Jerry's hardcore, man. He's been doing it forever, and he's a tough guy. Can't nothing put Jerry down, man. He's tough.
We were actually had a chance to see him at the store a couple weeks ago, you know, and Jerry was talking about driving tactics. And he was telling me, you know, it ain't always in the motor, boys. You got to know how to trick the man up that's riding behind you to think you're fixing to do something. And he got to spitting off all these Chinese words at me, man. I had no clue what he's talking about, but daggone fit didn't work because, you know, every time I turn around, I see him down there in the victory lane, either at Dublin or Fayetteville Motor Speedway. So,
yeah, I think Jerry's won, I think, 6 this year at Fayetteville.
That's awesome, man.
I mean, he's been killing it.
So. We're going to get Jerry in here in the show too, man, one day, you know, and we'll have to definitely get Jerry's autograph. AJ, see if we can get him on the wall.
Man, I'll tell you, I had the opportunity and the privilege to race against Jerry Johnson in Super Street and in Open Wheel, and I'm going to tell you what, man, that was it was a little nerve-wracking seeing that 98 behind you, buddy. Cause you know,
get you nervous because, hey, he'll shoot you the bumper if
he has
to.
Not only that, but, I mean, you know you're an elite company when you got Jerry Johnson. Now, he's been out there forever.
It was crazy. We were talking the other day when we had the Junkyard Dog in here, and he said – and Jerry started outside pole in their first race ever. They didn't know who was the scaredest, him or Jerry. You know, but now look at what, you know, Mr. Johnson's doing. And, you know, talking about, we were actually talking about doing some stuff on the show, not taking the limelight off of you, Robbie, but we were talking about doing some stuff on the show with Ladies of Racing. Mm-hmm. And, man, Miss Lisa's been right beside him. Mm-hmm. Every time Jerry's trailer pulls up, Miss Lisa hopping out the side of it.
She's the first one out.
Yeah. So, you know, big thanks to that family. And thank you, man. Your powertrain's obviously putting them in the winner's circle a lot, along with Jerry's crazy driving he's got going on there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we enjoy going watching Jerry and, you know, all the guys that run our motors. And we appreciate our customers, and we try to go to racetrack and help them as much as we can.
Yeah. Awesome, man. Well, it's great to have you in today. Is there anything else that, you know, tell them your phone number or a way they can get in contact with you? We definitely, anybody that's out here and you're looking to get a motor built, we've brought you the man to do it. Right here it is. I mean, you're looking at the straight name. You've heard of people he's putting in the winner's circle. We'll hear some more from Old Dirty when he comes up here about Robbie Draughon, Powertrain Development.
And you're keeping your money local, too.
Yeah. So, you know, how can they get up with you, man?
Just give us a call, 910-988-2619, or you can message us on Facebook, Robbie Draughon Powertrain Development, or visit our website, rdpdengines.com.
All right, brother. Well, I'll tell you what, man, let's throw us a caution. We're going to come back with the Redline Speed Shop Weekly Winner Circle with Racin Ryan.
Did you forget to back off the throttle after leaving the last race? Got caught doing a little more than the law will allow? Let us help you. Boost Law Office at 214 Dick Street, Fayetteville, North Carolina, has over 35 years of trial experience. From speeding to a trunk full of shine, we're the ones that can get you off the line. Call Jordan Stewart or Michael Boost today for a free consultation at 910-486-9292 or look us up at boost-law.com. Want to get that winner's circle look before you even get to the track? Well, say goodbye to that bushy mess and hello to the look of sheer success with Eastover Barbershop. Located conveniently off I-95, exit 56 on Dunn Road, directly in front of Eastover Fire Department. At a.m. to 6 p.m., Tuesday through Friday, specializing in all men's and boys' cuts, styles, and shaves. Best barber by Reader's Choice, 2 years running with over 21 years experience. We have what it takes to give you that winning look. Call Eastover Barbershop today at 910-751-0964.
Back at the steel, AJ. Man, was that not great to have Robbie Draughon in the house? You know, a lot of horsepower was just sitting in between me and you. I don't know if that sounded right, but whatever.
Other than the horsepower we've already got.
Yeah, no doubt. Man, it was great to have him on the show. And you know what? It takes guests like Robbie and the ones that we've had come in prior to really make this show count. You know what I'm saying? And we're just fortunate enough to have friends and to have those folks to come out and sit here and talk to us a little bit about and spread the word about horsepower and what it takes to get around that track and, you know, us trying to put him, the person, in their lap.
Yeah, absolutely.
Robbie Draughon Powertrain Development lap dance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to feel the power between your legs. He can do motorcycles engine too. So ladies, if you need that kind of horsepower, you go.
No doubt.
I mean, we're going to try to keep it a little bit PG rated, but you know.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Let's take it down to the pits like we were saying for the Redline Speed Shop weekend, Redline Speed Shop Weekly Winner Circle.
All right, so this week's edition is all about Clary's Speedway. It was a two-night event, Friday and Saturday. Me and my brother were in attendance. The I-95 race, $8,900 Montclair Memorial. Dustin Mitchell won that race. He went flag to flag. The open wheel modified race, Ryan Toole was declared the winner. That was a very good race. The limited sportsman, Chris Radford. The pure stock VH, Travis Wells. The super stock four cylinders was Gary Dillon, and the pure stock four cylinders was Brent Atkinson. Also in the U cars, it was Michael Wallace.
Oh, Brent Atkinson, man. I used to race mud racing with Brent Atkinson in the Flamin' Pastry, and he sure knew how to make that pastry on the bang. Yeah, that was the name of it. I have to tell you the story when we come back.
That sounds like some cooking that I do.
It was wild. I'll tell you that story. But you know what? We got something special here tonight. We had somebody call us. They said, Rooster, is there any possible way that I can come into the show? And I was like, well, that's if you want to, no problem. So we're going to get him to come in here this evening. And we're going to let him come in here. Yeah, I don't even know what else to say.
I don't think there's anything else to say. We'll just let this.
Let it roll out. You know what I mean? I didn't know that we were doing, you know, the dating show or anything like that. But we need to span it over, man. Span it over.
Yeah. We got. Swanee is just not on it. I think he's thinking about the Lucas Oil.
So we have had some straight up dating game deal going on right here.
Wow.
Which is it's Fussell being nice, man. Fussell's nice. And he I mean, who wouldn't bring our beautiful Shine Girls roses?
Exactly.
I mean, he beat me to the punch. Yeah. I got you a beer can. I mean, that's not quite as nice as what Fussell's did, but sweet gesture, man. I mean, I'm gonna tell you what, you got credit from me if you want to go out on a date, not with me, but somebody else. I'll get you signed up. I can promise you.
You have to bring him 12, but it's gonna have to be Bud Lights if you want to go on a date
with
him.
Yeah.
And a boat on a trailer.
And a boat. But that's anything can happen around this joint. You know what I'm saying? Anything. But what's happening right now is we have got the man in the house, Ryan Ivey, right here from the Rattlesnake. Man, it's great to have you in. Greatly appreciate you coming down. You're doing the PR work for Dublin. You're also the track photographer down there as well, man. You know, tell us a little bit about Dublin, and we definitely got to know what's up with the Rattlesnake.
First of all, thank you all for having me. There's a myth or a legend or a story behind the Rattlesnake, and I'm not sure if I'm going to get it straight or not or get it right or not, about somebody that went hunting many years ago out on the property, and I guess the guy got missing or didn't show back up, come home or something. And when they found the guy, he was actually out there in one of the little buildings, and he had died from a rattlesnake bite.
Man, let's hope that don't happen at the pool hop in Baywood this weekend.
No, but let me real quick. So at Edro's Tiki Bar, don't be surprised if you find a couple snakes underneath the Tiki Bar. And Bell Jr., who's in the house tonight, would be the first one to go up there and grab that thing right out from under and drag it out. So I didn't mean to, but you joked about it, but it's actually... Might happen.
Yeah, no doubt. And I had heard that story, too, as well as the rattlesnake. And it'll bite you if you ain't careful.
And from time to time, you know, throughout the racing year, we see three or four show up on a Saturday night from time to time, so in different places.
You know, y'all got a lot of cool stuff going on down there this weekend, man. The Carolina Sprints are coming into town. You got a lot of cool payouts that are happening. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about these sprint cars that are going to be there Saturday night.
Yeah, we got the 305 Sprints, the Carolina Tour Series, showing up this weekend. Be glad to have them back. We also have our limited late models that are actually shooting for, running for like $2,000 to win, $100 pole award. We've actually added some purse money, second place through fifth place for those guys to make them race a little bit harder. We also have a pole award in our pure stock and our Super 3 class this week.
That's awesome stuff. You know, and something that we had talked about, because we actually went down, and there's not too many times that Dublin rains out.
No,
at all.
At all.
They usually get that track ran back in and back in action, but the other night was a gully washer, and, you know, you guys called the race, and tell a little bit to the folks that are out there watching, you know, if they've got that wristband, it's good for this weekend, correct?
Yeah, unfortunately, we did have a rain out, was it the 24th, when the Ultimates were supposed to be here, and it was a gully washer at the last minute, but fortunately, we were able to call it early. The wristbands will be good this week, so make sure the people have held on to them and bring them back, and it won't cost them anything to get in, so...
And that $2,000 to win coming up this weekend, man, that's going to put them limiteds on a roll out there.
Yeah.
You know, you got a lot of good limited drivers that are – do you have, you know, some of the guys that are going to be coming out to race this weekend, the info on?
Normal, just the normal guys. I'm hoping to bring everybody because I know Fate was running Thursday night this week, which is good, with the Super Late Model race coming on. Hopefully them guys can go run Fayetteville Thursday night and then, you know, get it washed up, cleaned up, scale it out, and bring it back and see us on Saturday night.
Awesome, man. Awesome. You know, we wanted to talk a little bit about you guys have a candy drop that's coming up.
Dino Don
is sponsoring the candy drop. Yeah. And, you know, that's something else cool, you know, that's kind of added to the feature of it gets the kids involved. And now tell us, what is a candy drop?
Pretty much what they do is somebody wants to sponsor a candy drop, get up with me sometime, you know, during the week before that Saturday night. And we'll get the candy picked up, give it to Miss Shirley there, and they'll get it up there. And during intermission, after qualifying, they'll go up in the flag stand, sometimes down in the pits as well, and they'll throw out six or seven huge bags of candy to those kids. And they're standing around with their shirts held out, hats in their hand, bags, buckets, everything else. So,
that's awesome, man.
Yeah, the kids are happy, but probably the parents aren't when they eat the candy when they go home.
Yeah.
It's kind of like Halloween all in one night, man. You know, you get this whole big thing.
Every Saturday night is Halloween. You have to go get it. We're going to bring it to you.
That's great, man. You know, and cool, I've been going to Dublin. I can remember back in the day whenever the light bulbs was actually strung across the track. And when they went down in turn one, you couldn't even see the car.
It'd go down all the way out of sight.
Yeah.
And then come back up the back.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That was a big track back in the day.
And they, we had Mike Parker on here the other night. We had Burt Kitchen on the other night. You know, and that's one thing that they were talking about. It was a while to get down that backstretch. So if you had to make up your mind on the last lap, you had time to do it at Dublin Speedway.
Yeah. It's like a Talladega of dirt tracks.
Yeah.
It was a full half mile, so back then.
Yeah. And they talk about what they got coming up this weekend. Wanted to fall in there a little bit, AJ, and talk about, you remember what happened at Triple T the other weekend.
Mm-hmm.
With those guys, those race teams actually put money in for those kids in the kid kart division.
Right.
It was good to see the North Carolina Nightmare pick up his Sackett W.
Again.
Fourth win in a row. You know what I mean? He picked up his Sackett W in North Carolina. And, you know, those guys and ladies of those race teams come together and made some stuff possible. You know, I wanted to give a shout-out to some, Doug McLean Trucking gave $100 for the longest tow award. Lundy Motorsports is providing $100 to halfway leader. That word I can't spell, auto sports, is providing a receiver spec, RR, for hard luck award. You know, you got B4 Builders is sponsoring $50 extra to fourth place feature finisher, $25 for fourth place heat race finisher. Brandon and Jake McLean are providing $100 off the dyno session at Moss Racing Engines. T&S Outdoors is donating an extra $100 to the first time winner, only if the winner has not won an IMCA sanctioned receiver event in the Carolinas in 2017. So there's a lot of people coming together for you guys down there in Dublin. And what we've seen with Shine Runners Racing Radio is it takes us all.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It really does. It takes us all. And you know, give us your aspect as far as all these teams that are coming together to put this extra money, $300 extra in for first, $200 extra for Sackett. You know, there's so much that are coming together for everything down in Dublin this weekend.
It's people that love the sport. It's like you guys. You're promoting everything within the region, which has not really been done that much before, and it's greatly appreciated. I mean, it's welcome. We appreciate it. I'm sure everybody does. But to have somebody, you know, going on top like this and putting this kind of money, it's people that love the sport, that want to promote the sport and bring more people to the sport.
And, you know, that's what we've got to do is, you know, we can't have favorites back and forth between, you know, any kind of classes, tracks, you know, drivers. We've all got to work together. Because we're setting an example for all these kids that are going out there at the candy drop. They're watching what's going on, man. I can tell you my kid, Blaze, 2.5 years old. He knows what's going on, Jack.
Well, we've actually had this has been a vital point for Shine Runners.
Mm-hmm.
Is we are so fortunate with there's drag racing, there's mud bogging, there's round track, there's places to go run mod lights, legend cars, go-karts within a 50-mile radius of everywhere. You know what I'm saying? So we're so fortunate to have that. And here's the thing what a lot of people don't think of. If you cut a track out, you cut them down, you cut them out, that's one track we lost.
Yeah.
Then you got to haul 2.5 hours to get to somewhere.
It's going to cost you more fuel.
More time, more
fuel,
more everything.
On your car.
So, you know.
Yeah. And that's you're exactly right, man. Brian, we've got a lot of things. Even as we were speaking, you know, earlier, this Carolina Sprint Saver Series that's coming into town, that's something a lot of folks don't get to see around here that much,
you won't.
And so to be able to have a chance to go to Dublin, that's right in your backyard, and watch these cars go around, that's something. I mean, and they get on it. Them sprint cars put on some good racing, man.
Yeah, they're full-size sprints just like you see on TV and everything. They're 305s, but they're not short on horsepower and power and speed.
Yeah,
but they get around there pretty quick.
And while we're actually talking about sprint cars, we definitely want to let everybody know, please keep Guy Griffin, the number 11 sprint. He was critically injured in a crash, you know, and he's been in ICU, this, that, and other. And, you know, we definitely want to keep his family in our prayers and all that stuff.
Yeah, and like you see on the screen right there, if you may have seen this, folks, on Facebook, that's what a lot of people are putting on their profile pictures to support them. And you know, the racing community, even when – unfortunately, terrible things like this happen, we all band together because we keep preaching it. Racing is one family.
One family.
It doesn't matter if it's drag racing, go-kart racing, round track racing. It's all one family.
And we seen that the other day at Mr. Blackwell's, Mr. Blackwell's funeral. We were actually able to make it down there. And, man, they was racers from all over that came that, gosh, I haven't seen in years. You know what I mean? But it just proves that racing is all one family.
Yeah, absolutely.
Know? And, you know, wanted to tap into a little bit too, Brian. You're the photographer.
Right.
You know, not only do you do PR, you do photography, just that and the other. And, you know, tell us a little bit about what drives you to get these pictures of these cars.
I actually been doing it about 10 years, and I picked up on some of the stuff as just a hobby. Back when I first got started, and I was at Fayetteville for a little bit, just taking pictures as a hobby. Well, people got to look, I got to posting them, people got to looking at them, and they got to liking them, and one thing leads to another, and they start buying them. So basically, my first probably working for the track would be at Dublin. I started there 5 or 6 years ago, and I was there a couple years, left there, come up to Fayetteville for a couple years. Then I've gone back down to Dublin for last year and this year. So,
And so it's GWC Photography, and where that you've got a Facebook page,
I do.
Correct? And yes. How can people get in touch with you if they want to maybe buy some of the pictures you took for that weekend?
They can message me on Facebook, just my regular Facebook page. I have a Facebook page for my GWC Photography. If they want to get a hold of me as far as text message, my number is 910-263-6345.
And I want to say I really appreciate GWC Photography is also you know, a customer of Bellinger Signs and Graphics. And as the owner of that, man, I appreciate you keeping it local and getting it from us.
Wanted to throw out a little word about these Raging Rooster wings we got out front here. Mm-hmm. How about that? Did you get
they
a taste
awesome.
Of some of that?
I did. The corn's amazing.
We've been trying to tell everybody about this corn, bud.
I'd eat the corn before I'd eat the wings again.
And tonight, a free chance to win tickets to go to the race tomorrow. So, y'all, out there in the viewing audience, don't forget, you still have time. Raging Rooster set up right outside. Come on by, get yourself something to eat tonight, and get entered to win them Wayne Gray Memorial tickets that are coming up tomorrow, man. It's going to be a great show. I honestly can't wait to turn Swanee loose on that.
I can't wait to turn Swanee loose on a karaoke microphone because he's been talking about all week how he's going to do it, and I ain't going to let him get away without singing some kind of song out there at the Flying Ed trailer.
No doubt. Man, you were also talking, Brian, about some upcoming races. Y'all got some pretty big money rolling in the house down in Dublin.
Yeah, we've got, like I say, the sprints coming this weekend with the limited late models running for $2,000. We've got some unsanctioned super late model races coming up in August and probably September. We've also got, end of this month, the Southeastern Dirt Modified Series returns. They're going to run for $3,000 to win as well.
That's awesome, man. You know what? We got something. We got our ladies, our shine girls. I think they got a question
for you. I feel like it's a fishing pole over there. Every time we see a little jiggle on it, we know we got something. Yeah. We got a nibble.
Nibble and snatch, baby.
That's right.
Chad, I cannot pronounce his last name, Pulliam.
That's it. That's correct.
Asks, does the wings go well with the beer nuts as a chaser?
Absolutely.
Beer nuts.
I got some. See, everybody didn't know it, but I keep my head right over here. Have you had
anybody,
any?
Have you got? Everybody got beer nuts spent around? There should be beer nuts on the table. You know what we want to do? Brian, have you ever had these?
Not yet.
But let me tell you what. From Indiana.
Illinois.
I get it wrong every time. I'm so good at getting it wrong. You know what I mean? It's like, I'm like the
Nikki
best.
Told me.
At getting it, yeah. Anyhow, we need everybody out there. If there's beer nuts on that table, we want y'all to pick some up, try some. Because let me tell you what, these things are off the chain. Mm-hmm. And these guys is actually a sprint car, one of the sprint car drivers. He sent these things down. He's like, you guys have got to try these, man. So, you know. Pick them up, man. Y'all try some. Tell us what you think. What do you think, man? They
awesome.
All right?
They're good, yeah.
Have you tried the bar mix?
Just need some beer, though.
Hey, grab me one of them, too, man.
Raging Rooster Wings has hooked us up. We've got Bud Light products. Anybody else need one? Need some beer nuts or bar mix or whatnot? But
refresher.
Yeah, a refresher. So, you know, if you check them out, man, go to their Facebook page, look up Beer Nuts, and send them a review. Say thank you for sending that stuff to Shine Runners Racing Radio. It's
pretty
good,
absolutely.
Man. You know, and also, check out Dublin. Where can they get in contact with you guys? See the information, y'all Facebook pages, Instagram, all that?
Yeah, they got Facebook. There's also the DublinMotorSpeedway.com website and everything. And they can go either there or just get a hold of me, either one.
And that pretty much tells, you know, what you got coming up and seat prices and stuff like that. Because seat prices fluctuate, you know, depending on big races,
depending
this,
big
that,
races,
and other. So what's your normal general admission?
Stands for 15, fits for 25.
And that's a very cheap price to pay. When you actually get to thinking about it, there's a lot of time and money that goes into preparation for these tracks, that goes into payout for these tracks. And how many guys and ladies do you guys have working down there? I mean, that's... Gosh, it's got to be 40 plus.
I don't know if it's 40. We got a handful though.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they tote their own weight, man. They work hard. You know, I mean, Richard being a promoter, I mean, it's not just a promoter. He's out there working all week long doing track prep.
Yeah.
You know, watering, blading.
And that's the thing, you know, too, what a lot of people don't realize is you go out and you track prep starting Tuesday or Wednesday to race on Saturday, and then it gully washes.
You got
to
start all over again.
You
got to
start all over again. You know what I'm saying? So that money that's not being taken in from that weekend, now you got to start all the way back over. So $15 is not a lot of money when it comes to going to watch a good event.
Not especially when you count in fuel prices or what it costs to run those motor graders and, you know, anything like that. That's the thing that a lot of people don't think about with racetracks. They think, oh, you just get out there on a tractor and run. Well, that tractor's got to have some kind of diesel fuel or something to run.
Yeah,
you know,
any kind of moisture gets on the track if it rains, and we can get it running again. But you're out there with a motor grader, the water truck, everything else, packed cars, you know, for another 2 or 3 hours. Because like you said earlier, you know, if it rains, we don't rain out a lot of times at Dublin. We just delay. Because Richard, if you want to race, he'll stay. If you want to stay,
I've seen that happen.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, I was down there talking. He said, I forget who it was I was talking to last week. He said, man, I got to give it to them. We were down here. It took us a couple hours, but they got it run in, and we raced.
Yeah.
So, but just remember that. You don't have, you know, those tractors don't run on thank yous.
Mm-hmm.
No, not on water or air either. So.
Yeah. You know, it's an awesome time, man. I'm looking forward to seeing what happens this weekend down in Dublin with the Carolina Sprints. And Brian, thank you so much for coming out tonight and being a supporter of Shine Runners Racing Radio as well as us supporting Dublin and everything, man. You have no clue how much I appreciate it, and as well as the rest of the crew. Is there any questions? Do y'all have any questions for Brian? Anybody? Is there any questions come in?
Anything from our studio audience?
Any questions?
I feel like they're all. We told them all if they were going to watch the show, keep it, the volume down.
We're pretty informative.
I think they all get a little scared and just kind of, oh, I don't want to say nothing.
Yeah.
Or unless you're like me and you don't pay attention and you don't turn your phone down and it goes off, you know.
Well, that's all I have. Do you have anything else? If not, man, I think we'll throw a caution, and then we'll come back with Redline Speed Shops, the whole what's going on, the weekly race report with Racin Ryan. It's your job to put it in the winner's circle, but it's ours to make your ride stand out above the rest. With full-colored wraps or die-cut designs, Bellinger Signs and Graphics is sure to put you in the eyes of the fans. That's not all. We do custom yard signs, storefront, and your everyday decal. Come see us today at Bellinger Signs and Graphics, 3392 Dunn Road, Eastover, North Carolina. In the house here at the Steel as we are getting ready. Man, that was a great interview with Brian. You know, a lot of cool stuff going on down in Dublin.
And this, man, it's so awesome to have people from all the racetracks around here. I mean, we've got to start reaching out also to some of our, you know, the region. We need someone from County Line to come in here.
Yeah.
You know, we so far, let's see, we got to get Bill, as you like to say, Bill Doberman.
Bill Doberman.
Yeah.
Blah,
we got to get him on, and I think we've got him scheduled.
Yeah, he's coming in next week, actually. And we got some drivers that are actually going to be coming from Rockfish. And speaking of drivers and all types of different tracks, let's go down to the pits, ladies and gentlemen, the Redline Speed Shop Weekly Race Report with Racin Ryan.
All right, so we're going to kick it off early tomorrow, July 6th. It'll be the race day party at the Dunn Benson Ford. You can come out and see the 21 Wood Brothers car. There's going to be quite a few late models out there that'll be in the Wayne Gray Memorial. And then that night, we will have the Wayne Gray Senior Memorial presented by Campbell University. Late models, limited late models, Diet Mountain Dew Modified, Super Streets, Camper World Pure Stocks, and U-Cars. July 7th, the Freaky Friday at the Fayetteville Motorsports Park. July 7th and 8th, the VW Drag Night, Orangeburg Drag Strip. That's in Neasa, South Carolina. July 8th, the Carolina Sprints invade the Dublin Motor Speedway. July 8th, the County Line Ultimate Series, $4,000 to win super late models. July 8th, the Rockfish Speedway will have the Mod Lights, the Sprints, and the Legends. July 8th, the Swamp Fox Complex, the Mud Bog Motor Jam Consistency Challenge in Marion, South Carolina.
I believe somebody has let him in our cooler.
Yes. Have we not got somebody in here, ladies and gentlemen? That number 88 machine coming up. Old Dirty, Daniel Johnson. Man, Daniel, it's... Wow.
Everybody, you might want to go outside.
Same thing happened last week.
You might want to go outside and check your fenders on your cars because Dirty's here.
Dirty's in the house. You know, we before we throw this out there, ladies and gentlemen, I want to let everybody know the number 88 driver here, Johnson and Hardee Enterprises Super Street Machine, Daniel Johnson, Old Dirty in the house.
And still dirty.
And still dirty. We got to know about that because we have heard that you were Old Dirty and still dirty. What's going on with all that?
We were trying to figure out something to put on the back of the car this year, and I don't remember who came up with it, if it was Robbie or somebody. We were trying to figure out something to come on the car. We didn't put Old Dirty on it. And I think Robbie said put Steel Dirty on it or something. I can't remember what it was. And we ended up settling on that Steel Dirty. A friend of mine stuck me with that Old Dirty name a couple years ago, and it's just stuck.
And, like dirt.
Yeah, like dirt. Mud. It's Old Dirty.
Well, let me tell you how to fix something that won't stick. This right, Neverlift right here, Neverlift Farmer Coat. You know what I'm saying?
Little
it's going to get
melon?
All melony here in a minute. Melanie. I dated her for a long time. Anyhow, Neverlift Race Products got this armor. Have you tried this?
Not yet.
It's some good stuff, and Redline Speed Shop carries it, man. That powertrain development deal you got going on with Robbie Draughon, yeah, he's got some of that at his store. So get a chance, man. Get on down there and get you a can.
It smells good.
It does. It smells melon.
Yeah.
You know,
we're gonna put a can of it in the restroom here at Bellinger Signs and Graphics.
Yeah.
Just for those certain situations after like Micositas or something.
Well, it helps prevent mud and dirt from sticking. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying.
It probably helped a lot of stuff from sticking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, I tell you, you know, you come down. I seen you a lot in Pure Stock. Where did you actually start out at in racing?
Oh, I actually started out at U-Car. Well, we started out Enduro years ago, but they quit doing Enduros, and then we moved to U-Car. A friend of mine, Robbie, he said, you know, Robbie Williams, he said, let's build some U-Cars. So we built U-Cars, and ever since then, it's been like a drug, I guess. You hook to it, I guess.
Yeah, that red clay will get you every
time.
It'll
get you.
You know, you're running the Robbie Draughon power plant in that machine as you were doing back in Pure Stock. And I'm going to tell you what, man, we were actually at the race the other night. It's been almost a month ago. Mm-hmm. You were in Pure Stock, and Dad was talking about that was probably the best Pure Stock race he's ever seen in his life when y'all were back and forth, just,
yeah.
I mean, giving it heck, man. And, you know, that's the good part about racing. A lot of times you see people freight training, but y'all were putting on a show for the crowd, and that's what everybody pays to see.
Yeah, it was fun. Definitely Jimmy. I mean, every time me and Jimmy run together, we never – yeah, we'll rub, but, I mean, as rubbing's racing. You're going to rub. I mean, you're on dirt. But, like I said, we had fun, and that's the first time we brought the car out this year. We actually haven't even really touched the car since the end of last year because we got the Super Street deal going on, so we really won't prepare to run both cars. But it was big money on the line, and we wanted – 2 years ago, I believe it was 2 years ago or last year, we'd won that memorial race. We want to try to do it again. And we led 14 and a quarter out of 15 laps.
Man.
And, you know, getting back to what you were just talking about, you and Jimmy, I mean, you guys are always right up there racing against each other. And the respect, you can tell it as from a driver's standpoint, the respect that you guys have. Y'all are going in there side by side a lot of the times. And, I mean, that's do you trust him more than maybe you trust somebody that you don't know when you're on the racetrack?
All the guys.
Are you just going for the win?
Well, you know, I was going for the win. But, like I said, all the guys that run Pure Stock, I mean, Rick, Martin, I mean, everybody in Pure Stock, them, we kind of all respect each other because we know how much it costs if we tear them up. Mm-hmm. You know, if you run in there and just tear them up, you know, then you might have to sit out a week. And that's kind of how the Old Dirty got. You know, I used to be – when I used to race a couple of years ago, I used to go out there and just freight train, but
right.
I learned it gets expensive.
Oh, it does.
I could imagine, you know, and not trying to get off the subject of Super Street. We're going to tap into that and staying with Pure Stock because, man, I'm going to tell you what, I saw you a lot in the Winter Circle, you know, with that thing. And even got here, this came in, the Friday Night Fights champion.
Yeah.
You know, that number eight, man, that. You were really making it happen. Also, the Brian Honda Pure Stock Blitz champion. So you picked up some championships in that ride.
Yeah, we ran last year. We was wanting to run for points, but we kind of fell out of the points deal. And we said, well, we'll just try to go for the Friday night fights and the Blitz. And we did it, man. I tell you, Robbie's built my motor into Pure Stock now for 5 years. And then he's also built a motor in a super street car owned by Mr. Hardee. And I tell you what, if you want some horsepower, you got to go over and get some.
Mm-hmm. I heard that. You know, and the reasoning behind getting you here tonight, we want to talk about the Wayne Gray Memorial tomorrow. That's a big race. It's I mean, you got the World of Outlaws that'll be coming to Fayetteville, you know.
No, Lucas Oil.
I'm talking about later on down the road. They usually have World of Outlaws, but Lucas Oil's going to be in here. And that's a big, I mean, that's it a is, big
yeah.
event.
Both of them are, yeah.
And getting prepared for something like that, that's where I was trying to go to with before you rudely interrupted me.
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
You know what I mean? Let me pump the brakes just a little bit, Pa. Nah. What we're saying, but something like that for a big event, what's your strategy as far as getting the car ready? Do you double check it more than you do on a regular Saturday night? How does it work out?
I mean, we go over the car every week, but like I said, we get to run, in front of that crowd, in front of that, the caliber of cars are going to be there, because they're going to be out there watching us too. So you want to go out there and put on a good show, for anybody, even on a weekly event, but. Just like, I was talking to Donovan Jackson. I worked with him, and me and him was talking a little while ago before we come out here. And, he's over going over his, and I was going over mine. And my car was ready to race last weekend, but Dublin got rained out, so I just kind of pushed back in the shop. And I was out there going over again, even though I know I went over it, just making sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's definitely a full-time job, man, because if you're like me, you're out there and you start second-guessing yourself.
Yeah.
Did I check that? Yeah, I think I did, but let me check it again.
Well, there's been times.
So you're going to be running the Super Street this weekend,
yep,
or excuse me, tomorrow night, tomorrow as a matter night. Of fact. And do y'all have any plans on going anywhere else to race this weekend?
If we can make it through Thursday night, we might try to go to Dublin. Here, our finishing rate at Fayetteville here the last couple races hasn't been real good. Just getting caught up in some accidents. Like I said, we got the car really, the car really got banged up, about 3 weeks, a month ago. And we got it back together. We missed the race, but it rained out at Fayetteville, so. But we got it back together. We've changed everything under the car. We're going back to my old drawing board, my pure stock. We're going to try it and see if it works.
Rudely interrupt me.
Sibit.
Pop the brakes.
Two.
Sibit.
Two.
.com.
No,
go ahead, man.
You know what? The pure... Y'all should see our outtake reels. We can't even post them. They're so bad. But going back, the pure stock last year, as long as you've been running, it's just constant success, man. I mean, you're always, always at. Can you get that picture back up there, Swanee? Let's see if we can pull it back up. I think it's right there. That one, how long have you had that car?
I've had that car for 7 years.
Wow.
And
now, does everybody... In the pure stocks now, can you run aftermarket body?
Yes, you can run aftermarket body.
But you choose to continue to run the old school.
Yeah, I mean, that's old school pure stock. I mean, me and Jimmy, everybody says sheet metal's the way to go. Lighter's better. Well, I mean, it goes to show you the old stock body cars, a few weeks ago, they'll still get it done.
Exactly.
I mean, they're heavy, but, it works.
Good deal.
Man, as well, like we say, coming up, we got to try something. We got something on the line. And speaking of Boom City, mm-hmm. we have got bomb energy drinks that have just got dropped off by Mr. Gary.
Right.
So we have got, in honor of the Boom City race tomorrow night, we need to try out this bomb energy drink we got here.
Well, let's do it.
It's X-Bomb.
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 Energy.
There is no telling what's fixing to happen. Here, you can have mine.
Yeah, this one, I'll take that
here,
one.
I'll share, Bo. I'll share. We got plenty more of here for everybody to try one.
We'll try that one. We'll try the sugar-free.
Anybody else want one?
These are really good. They taste just like Red Bull, but better.
Not too bad.
Huh. Yeah.
Let's try it out.
Y'all go. Okay, you're good.
Wow, it does taste like Red Bull.
It does. Just like
it's even actually better.
Maybe you can use it with Jägermeister.
Well, Robbie Draughon, they said that we could use this with Jägermeister. So you want to go sing some Boys to Men or something this weekend?
I'm retired from singing.
He just builds motors.
And while we got our main man here in the house, don't forget, if anybody's got any questions, just type them in, and we'll go ahead and get the questions over to Old Dirty. And, from our Shine Girls, has anybody chimed in that y'all see?
And while we're waiting on that, it might be a good time to go ahead and maybe put out this week's trivia question, Redline Speed Shop trivia question.
We can do that.
Okay.
Don't forget, you need to turn my phone, turn that off, turn my phone up. The phone number is 910-237-1343. 910-237-1343. Write that down. Go ahead, Racin Ryan. You got that question?
All right. The question is, who was the last driver to win to have a Tampa race? I might need to repeat that. Who won the last have a Tampa race? There we go.
I don't even think Racin Ryan was. Were you even born when we had have a Tampa at Fayetteville Motor Speedway?
It's been a while. Have a Tampa's been a little
while.
With Swanee,
were you even born? Man, I'm old.
Man, so who was it that won the last have a Tampa race? Call us in at 910-237-1343, and we'll get you on the line here. Your chance tonight to win a set of Mini Bling's LED light modules.
And not to mention, but there's Raging Rooster's catering is still out there.
Yes.
I heard the sirens going off, so somebody might have got a hold of that bottle.
Yeah, well, Terry Odom can tell you all about the bottle. Did you have them wings?
Yes, I did.
Is that not some good eating?
They are some good wings.
Did you get your ticket in there for the chance to get in? Well, free, you got a free seat tomorrow. Your car. Yeah. You're sitting in the car.
He's got the best seat in the house.
He does. You know, you could actually give them tickets away. So make sure before we pull tonight that you get your name in that bucket, because that's a chance to win for the Wayne Gray Memorial tomorrow. Mm-hmm. You know, two free tickets come down. And while we're waiting on somebody to call, 910-237-1343, who was the last winner of the Have a Tampa race?
At Fayetteville Motor Speedway.
Want to thank Boos Law Firm. Jordan Stewart with Boos Law Firm, Michael Boos, because they're ones that helped us out for purchasing these tickets. Eastover Barbershop and Redline Speed Shop.
Really quick, I mean, I got to say, this is the first show I've done without a hat. And to be honest with you, man, I think old B. Egan did a great job.
Uh-oh. Let's see.
We got one on the line.
Let's see what we got. Hello, this is the Rooster. Who we got here?
This is Andrew Davis.
Andrew Davis. How you doing, my friend? What's that name? Wendell Wallace. Wrong. Sorry, brother. Google it and call me back. Hello. Who we got on here?
Lisa Johnson.
Rick Eckerd?
That is correct.
That is correct. Rick Eckerd, and you are picking up a set of Mini Bling's LED light modules. How you doing, Mama? Gosh, we were just talking about you.
Had daggone Johnson's.
We were. It was all good. It was all good. We want to get you on the show, too, because I tell you what, there's a lot of people who's been behind racing, and you've definitely been one of them. All right. Well, I don't need your address because I got it. What I'll do is when I'm headed back to the house, I'll just run them over there to you.
Thank you, babe. I appreciate it.
Thank you, darling. Thank you so much, and thank you all for watching.
And, you know, we thought we might be able to stump some people on that one.
Yeah.
Because, actually, Scott Bloomquist crossed the line first, but then Swanee.
Mr. Bloomquist,
yeah. Biggest fan in the world, yes. Jay Swan.
I think he's got his shirt on.
Can we span over there to Jay Swan and let him say what happened?
It might have been Bloomquist's underwear.
It was. It's just 5 pounds, boys. They could have let him slide on it, you know.
He probably shouldn't have took that dump before he went
probably,
out there.
Probably. Probably.
Could have been running armor coat.
Yeah, that's probably what happened.
5 pounds slid off the car.
Mm-hmm.
The scales were wrong. That's all there is to it.
It wasn't the last time he failed tech either.
Oh!
Racin Ryan coming out of the back corner. Let's go ahead and
let's just put it this way. Tomorrow night, I can go ahead. You can go ahead and mark it down. Aliens are going to land in Boom City because Scott Bloomquist is going to go to Victory Lane. Mark it down.
Hey, we need some.
Might land there. I don't know if they go to Victory Lane.
How many Scott Bloomquist fans have we got? Go ahead and tap in on the Facebook Live tonight, and let's find out exactly how many we got here.
You know what we should do? Everybody should go ahead.
Who are you pulling for?
Yeah, comment on there, and we should take a poll of what our fans, the driver they think will win the Lucas Oil Dirt Series. Could it be Earl Pearson Jr.?
Out of Dunn, North Carolina.
Willie Milliken.
Out of Roanoke.
Could it be Black Sunshine?
I don't know who that is. You could have said Black Jesus. I'd have had no clue.
But go ahead and comment on there and let us know who you think is going to win tomorrow night.
Come on the line.
Definitely, man. Well, who do you think is going to win, Racin Ryan? You're all about NASCAR, though, you know.
No, I wouldn't say that. If I had to go ahead and guess, I mean, Josh Richards is pretty hot right now. I mean, he's a good – that's not a personal favorite for me, but I'm just going off results.
And, you know, that team that he's been with this year, they've been knocking it out, man. They've been rolling out some wins.
What do you think? Well, we already know. Yeah, he said Aliens is going on.
He's about the only one in
America. What about
the
you,
check
old,
is already wrote. Yeah. I've already seen
he
it.
He probably
got
printed
it.
Dirty, you just made the comment that Swanee has probably got his Bloomquist underwear on.
He probably does.
Bloomers.
He loves Bloomer, man.
And they're pink.
And they're pink.
Don't he count gets, out Owens, he gets GR, mad. All them. And actually, we had Zach that was going to be coming on the show tonight. He had some stuff he had to take care of with the car to get prepared for tomorrow. Mm-hmm. But, you know, how about tomorrow's racing party down in Dunn? Are you going?
No, I got to work.
We'll send you a live feed.
That'll work.
Anybody, you know, don't forget tomorrow. If you got a chance to go down, I mean, there's going to be a lot of drivers there. I think Randy White's going. Randy White's usually everything. I mean, Randy White will show up.
I've been taking his classes.
Yeah. Randy White's going to be there. I know A.J. Bellinger's going to be there. The North Carolina Nightmare's going to be there, along with the big super late model drivers. It's going to be a huge party at Dunn Benson.
10 to 2.
Yeah, so make sure you get on down there. Speaking of $10,000 to win tomorrow night.
Yep.
Wow. Man, that's big stuff. And you can actually still have time to win a pair of tickets. Come here. I think Bobby Jackson is still out there cooking right now, if he's got any chicken wings left. And I know he's got fried corn. But you still got a chance to win. So anybody in here right now, go buy your drink.
Model Dirt Series is back at the track.
And, you know, turn it loose one time, Swanee. Turn that loose on that video there.
The Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series is back at the track in 2017. Today's hottest stars, young guns, veterans, and former champions put it all on the line. Come see the best dirt late model drivers in the nation and the most powerful cars on dirt rip their way to victory lane. Be there for all the action July 6th at Fayetteville Motor Speedway. For more info, call 910-223-7223 or visit FayettevilleMotorspeedway.com.
Back in it with it one more time, man. Before we get ready to get up out of here tonight, we've got to bring in one more person. So we're going to go to commercial here shortly. After we get done, Dirty, I can't thank you enough, man. And something you did tonight, you brought my old truck up here. But if there's any dads out there that are really upset about that yellow truck, just know that I sold it and Daniel's now driving it. So you can't be upset about it anymore. You know what I mean? But gosh, how long have you had that thing?
I've had it for 12 years.
Good Lord. That was my first truck.
12 years. Still the same.
A mini of Myrtle Beach.
Do you need some of this armor coat smelling from the inside of that truck?
I've already fumigated that one.
Yeah, it's probably some rust down there somewhere. But, man, we appreciate you coming out tonight. Is there anything that you can tell folks? Come out. See you tomorrow night. Let them know what you're going to be in. Throw your hand up for old Dirty when he comes through there at number 88.
I think they do it on a weekly basis anyway, but it ain't this finger.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We have, like I said, you have your local haters, but, hey, you know, that's what any deal.
If you don't got haters, you ain't doing something right.
At least you're not talking on the about top. Me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, at least they're talking about me. But, yeah, we'll be out there in 88 Super Street. Mr. Jim, he's gave me a great opportunity to drive the car this year, and I said, Robbie, hopefully we can get up there. I want to rub doors with Jerry Ho, anyway.
Yeah.
And, maybe we can get it up front this week.
That's awesome, man. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing you tomorrow night. And thanks so much for coming out to the show, Bo. It's great to have you on. And it's always good, man, to be sitting in with good company and, you know, drivers like yourself that support the sport and really get out there and make it happen, man. We got you a free pack of beer nuts for coming in the studio here tonight.
That's awesome.
But once again, we greatly appreciate you, man. Thank you so much. Take it down to caution one more time. Let's hit some commercials. We'll come back with a little pit chat.
Mm-hmm. We'll be back after these commercials.
I'm Bill W. with Rockview Speedway.
I'm Charlie Castle, race director of Fayetteville Motor Speedway.
I'm Thomas, driver number 50 Mile Life.
Hi, I'm Ben McCall, driver of the number 7 Austin Sprint.
This is my son, Brody Callahan. Driver of the junior dragster, Black Ops Paintball, and we're watching Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Hey, I'm Action Jackson, and you're watching Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Looking to ease the pain of cooking for your guests? Tired of hosting the party but staying on the grill all night? Let us help you. Raging Rooster, a fully functional rolling kitchen loaded with the official chicken wings of Shine Runners Racing Radio. Owned and operated by Tony and Bobby Jackson. Contact them at 910-237-4565 or jackson.bobby@yahoo.com. Raging Rooster Wings, come get you some.
Don't gamble with your plumbing. Let 1-800-PLUMBING deal you the winning hand every time. Our trained professionals have the knowledge it takes to turn any full house into a flush. Fully licensed and insured with over 70 years of experience, the staff of 1-800-PLUMBING is here 24 hours a day to show your queen you're the king of the castle. It's as easy as dialing 1-800-PLUMBING. That's 1-800-758-6246 when you need it done right.
All right, y'all, back in the house. AJ, man, you want to introduce our fine folks we have with us?
Who we've got right now with us is Jason and Caleb Brown. They were our weekly winners in the Like and Share Raging Roosters Catering Table of Champions. So they were able to come down here, eat some free food, enjoy the show. And, man, Caleb here is a quarter midget racer. And you race up in Salisbury?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And he has got a Facebook page, too, so let's go ahead and shout that out. It's Caleb Brown Racing. So y'all go on over there, give him a like on his Facebook page. And now I've heard that you're going to be moving from a quarter midget up to a sprint car out at the Rock of Hope.
Yes, sir. That's correct.
When do you think you'll be moving up to that?
As soon as Daddy forks out the money, right?
Yeah.
So ask him what he's waiting on, huh? Yeah. How's your racing season been going so far this year?
Pretty good so far.
How many you where you been finishing? You had some good wins, some wins, or
got first, third, pretty much top three.
Good deal, man.
Top three every week. That's good stuff, man.
And there's a lot of people don't know that there's a quarter midget track in Salisbury, North Carolina, and it's one of the nicest. And Jason and I were talking when he was up here getting some decals from us. There's actually a lot of NASCAR drivers that take their kids out there to race, or crew chiefs and such like that, right?
Oh, yeah. That's the majority of what's over there. I mean, you'll be racing against a guy, talking to him. Next thing you know, he's telling you he's got to go to Phoenix the next week for a NASCAR race.
Tell us a little about the quarter midgets for some of us that don't know much about it. I saw they kind of push those things off to get them started.
Yeah, they've got Honda 120 and 160 motors, and they've got full suspension, about like a sprint car. I mean, shocks, coilover shocks, whole nine yards. I mean, it teaches them a lot about racing. I mean, it's got true setups on it, and they run a small track, so they've got to learn to pass. It's not just riding around. They've got to do a lot of passing.
Yeah, and they've actually got like a Facebook page and website and all that, and I went and looked at it, man. It's like a top-notch facility. I mean, it's no joke.
Yeah, they're running the biggest race of the year right now is at Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Wow. We would be there if we hadn't already made our mind up to make this transition, but, I mean, I think there's a little over 400 entries at that track right now.
And how old are you, buddy?
I'm 13.
13 years old. So, you know, we've had a couple people in, don't even have driver's license, and winning races and doing big things in racing, man.
Never know. The next star might be right here on Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Well, we definitely need to get those autographs before he gets out of here, for sure. You know what I mean? Man, what made you, come on to Shine Runners Racing Radio? What was the draw for you to bring you on to even like our page?
Talk, boy. just the local connection. I mean, like I said, that's the biggest draw. You know, the only hold back with us racing quarter midgets, it's a long drive over there. So looking to get back local here, and this is – neat opportunity here, local racing. Glad to see it promoted like this.
Well, good. And now, so you were the winner of the Raging Roosters Catering Table of Champions. Did you like the food? Did you try some wings? What'd you guys get?
Yeah, both of us got garlic parmesan wings.
Man, those are my favorite.
Oh, yeah.
I love those things. Did you get
some fried
corn?
The fried corn?
No, I didn't. I forgot that.
We're about to pull that ticket for the Wayne Gray Memorial here when we come back for Pit Chat. So if anybody wants to go out there and purchase your last a drink, a piece of fried corn, one kernel of corn, whatever you want to purchase, you get a free raffle ticket to put in there to go to. Are y'all going to the Wayne Gray tomorrow?
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be a good show, man. We're actually going to be down there in Flying Ed's camper. We got the DJ equipment going to be set up, dance lights. There's going to be all kinds of stuff going on down at Flying Ed's tomorrow. So, you know, you guys stop by. We'll have the old 1941 Shine Runners Racing Radio car out there. Mm-hmm. And so y'all come on down, check it out. We're going to be passing out free stickers, this, that, yeah, and the other.
We may even have some hats if people have been asking about hats.
Yeah. So we're going to do a little pre-race show down there. So y'all definitely come on by and kick it with us for a little bit. We're going to have a good time before we get ready to go up there and watch some late model racing and super street racing. And they'll have a full line. Swanee, what is the lineup for tomorrow night? We don't have a lineup at the moment. Well, they're going to try to pull it up and see if we can find a lineup.
There'll be some racing. Racing will be going on.
Racing will be going on.
Racing, and then some more racing, and then a little more racing.
Yeah.
And possibly in between there, a little bit of beer drinking.
Yeah. And racing going on.
Yeah.
But we know Super Streets are going to be there because we had Daniel Johnson in the house, Old Dirty himself. He's going to be down there rubbing fenders with Jerry Johnson. So we'll see how that turns out in the long run, you know. I love you, Daniel, and everything, but I'm personally going to be pulling for Jerry. So, Yeah, you're right. No, man, it's all about everybody just out having a good time, and tomorrow is where you make it count, man.
Mm-hmm.
It really is. We got if somebody would go out there and grab that tumbler, we're going to make a last lap dash to get rid of some tickets. You know, if somebody wants to get one, you might as well go ahead and get that done, and we'll make that last lap dash to pull.
Cool.
Well, we appreciate you guys coming in the studio. Thank you so much, man, for liking and sharing and, you know, everything that you did to help us out in the long run.
And be sure to go and like Caleb's page on Facebook. It's Caleb Brown Racing. It's a quarter midget car, which he's moving up to. It's 270, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good deal, man. We look forward to seeing all that you're going to do out at the Rockfish Speedway. And we're going to have you come back on the show and tell us how that transition is going. All right.
And keep an eye out on the show next week. We've got Beer W.E.B.L.E.R. is going to be here. He's actually the track promoter. I can't say his last name.
Doberman.
Dobier.
You almost got it.
Deer, yeah.
Yeah.
Bill's going to be here next week, and he's going to be talking about Rockfish. So in my best radio voice, let me say that. But anyhow, I think we got Mr. Brown's going to be coming down from Brown Motorsports talking about Mod Light Racing. It's going to be going down there, and we got sprint drivers that are coming in next week. So it's going to be a good show, man. Tune in. We'll have all kinds of stuff about
y'all
the payout.
Yeah, y'all come down, because those guys, I'm sure, Jody McCall. I was telling Jason earlier, Jody McCall, man, building his own chassis, McCall chassis. Got to check him out.
Yeah. That's awesome, man. So we've actually got, well, we kind of did it a little different. We were going to bring the pail in here and draw it, but.
Yeah.
We appreciate it, Mr. Brown. He's already ahead of the game.
Oh, okay.
He's already threw the green flag, so he went out and snatched one, and it's Brian Ivey.
How about that?
I don't even think we need to call him. 263-6345. So, Brian,
He wasn't even in here when he won.
Yeah. Brian was the actual winner for the ticket that got pulled here this afternoon. So, thank you, Brian. And thanks for everybody else that actually come down to Raging Rooster and, you know, purchase from him this afternoon, as he's a big sponsor of ours to help us out.
Yep.
You know, it's awesome, man. Thank you. So we're going to do a little pit chat, man. We'll let y'all roll on, and y'all can hang out. We'd love to hang out with you after the show. But go ahead and take us down to a little commercial, Swanee, right quick, and we'll come back with just a little bit of pit chat.
Don't gamble with you.
You're watching Shine Runners Racing Radio.
Did you forget to back off the throttle after leaving the last race? Got caught doing a little more than the law will allow? Let us help you. Boost Law Office at 214 Dick Street, Fayetteville, North Carolina, has over 35 years of trial experience. From speeding to a trunk full of shine, we're the ones to get you off the line. Call Jordan Stewart or Michael Boost today for a free consultation at 910-486-9292 or look us up at boost-law.com.
Want to get that winner's circle look before you even get to the track? Well, say goodbye to that bushy mess and hello to the look of sheer success with Eastover Barbershop. Located conveniently off I-95, exit 56 on Dunn Road, directly in front of Eastover Fire Department. At a.m. to 6 p.m., Tuesday through Friday, specializing in all men's and boys' cuts, styles, and shaves. Best Barber by Reader's Choice, 2 years running with over 21 years experience. We have what it takes to give you that winning look. Call Eastover Barbershop today at 910-751-0964.
Here we go, man. We got the green flag flying back out here at the Steel. AJ, man, great show. You know, tonight was a great night. We actually, you know, had a lot of folks come out, purchase from Raging Rooster Catering, and Brian Ivey picked up the two free tickets.
Yeah, and, you know, how easy was that, Brian? There you go. Yeah. That's all you had to do.
And we're going to be doing that a lot more, mm-hmm. you know, coming up as well. Like we say, on the nights that we're running mm-hmm. here at the Steel, Raging Rooster's going to be set up. So you, it's kind of like this deal. You don't feel like cooking. You've been working all day. Slide by, get some wings, man. We've heard nothing but great reviews about them. Mm-hmm. You know, everybody else here on the panels ate some wings. What do y'all think?
Awesome, man. I think they still got their mouths full.
Yeah.
Corn's favorite.
Everybody likes that fry. What do you think?
I like French.
Me? You want to do sign language or? I mean, we go
she
both ways.
She likes barbecue wings. She yeah. likes barbecue wings.
No, I like buffalo wings.
But all kinds of good food, man, from Raging Rooster. And he's going to be all kinds of different places. So, you know, we'll try to keep everybody posted. If you're a friend or, you know, you want to run him down and pick it up and, you know, be great to have.
And if you're interested in having him come out to an event, he will cater an event, 25 or more people. You can go check him out on his Facebook page, or you can reach him. I don't think we've actually got it up, but it looks like we need a bell on that microphone yeah. over there. Shandy, what you
I
got?
I mean, I'm gonna start doing y'all like the
There you go.
Okay. So Chad Sexton says he has a question. He said, "Does the round track racing guys talk as much trash as in mud racing guys?"
I haven't seen it.
Not yet. They haven't been talking, but I tell you who does. And I'm going to go, them old drag racing boys, Stevie Jackson, will talk it.
Yeah.
I posted a video earlier this
old
week.
Old Bill will give you hell, too, brother.
Yes, sir.
You ain't careful. If you ain't careful, don't think you're just going to walk away.
No.
No. Old Bill will be giving it to us.
And we're going to see what we can do to maybe get old Stevie Fast Jackson on the show. If we can get him on the show, there will be some trash talking. So, we might even, I can tell you what, Stevie don't care. He'll get in a mud truck and he'll race chassis.
Which, you know what, the thing is, man, it's straight strip all the way. Them boys, it doesn't matter. It's mud versus asphalt.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, there's a grudge race, a dirty grudge race.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can make that happen. They actually got some good racing that's going to be coming up down at Swamp Fox mm-hmm. this weekend. It's the ATV park down there. They got side-by-side racing, mud bog racing, all kinds of stuff. And speaking of mud bogging, Jump and Run Creek. On the 15th, go down and check them guys out. In 200-foot flat tracks, they're running a 2.146. That's 2.146 seconds, man. That's riding. You know what I mean? And they got it coming up. Lee County Mud Motorsports Complex, that's a 250-foot track. They're running 3.649s. And the world record currently held by Rodney Hawk out of West Virginia is a 3.643, 250-foot of 4-foot mud. That's riding, bro.
We definitely going to have to make a trip down there for Flag Wars.
Yeah, that's going to be a good one. Yeah. But you know what we are making the trip for, and I'm super excited. I hope everybody joins with us tomorrow. We are going down to the Dunn Benson Ford
Race Day
Party. So what time does it start?
It starts at 10, and actually, if I don't say this, my wife will kill me, but Gaylord the Camel, the Campbell Camel mascot is going to be there.
Yeah.
So bring your kids, take a picture with him. I think she's going to try to get Blaze and Axel down there to get there. Pictures taken with the alma mater.
You're actually going to be down there with your legend car,
mm-hmm.
you know, and signing autographs and all as you do. The North Carolina Nightmare will be there too, little Wyatt.
He's going to sign more autographs than I am, I can promise you that.
I tell you, the other week, I just have to say this, I'm pretty proud of him. We were invited down to Paradise Acres. They have a classic car cruise in the first Sunday of every month. We were invited to go down. They had a cancer benefit going on. And that little joker, man, he walked around and sold autographs all day long. Had him a little to-go box, a food to-go box full of money. coins and dollars and stuff, and he went back and donated it to that boy that had melanoma cancer. Man, I thought that was pretty cool.
Well,
you know,
I'd say you're raising him up, right?
He actually hustled a little bit. He had him, he befriended the lip sense lady, and he just had him sitting up there. I think she was kind of pushing him for him. Yeah. He sweet talked her.
Well, every time I turn around, you know, all the little kids are out playing, and Wyatt's over there with the moms. I don't know where he got this from. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
He was.
Where he might have got that from, and a lot of that spawned off that yellow truck you drive. But but Swanee, tell us a little bit about tomorrow night, man. What time gates opening?
I think gates are open about 3 o'clock to give everybody time to slide down from Dunn and come to the track. Grandstand's at 4 o'clock actually. Hot laps is probably gonna get going about 7:30. Should be a good show.
It's gonna be an awesome show.
Yeah, and we're gonna be down there doing a pre-race show.
Yes.
At Hollywood Hotel and Flying Air Travel.
And if you come down, check us out. We got free stickers.
Mm-hmm. While supplies last.
Right. Yeah. And we got the karaoke machine that we're going to get Jay Swan, the new white chocolate rapper.
I think he was going to
down.
I think he's going to do Islands in the Stream.
Don't even bring that up.
Yeah. Let's talk about Swanee's nickname that we came up for him. He was, I'm going to let Magic Man tell him. Go on, Magic Man.
Nicknames from here at the show.
Back we had on our
spin it around to you so we can see your facial expressions while you're talking.
There may have been some that I just can't remember.
Swanee used to have this big. I mean, he still got his beard, but it was out there. That's why they call him Boob City Sasquatch. But I told him he looked like a mix between Kenny Rogers and Tim Richmond. So I was going to start calling him Kenny Richmond. If Kenny Rogers and Tim Richmond had a baby, that'd be Swanee.
There it is. Laugh it up, everybody.
But we're going to get him up there on the microphone to sing.
Yeah, tomorrow night. So if you got your karaoke on, we're going to go live. And we're going to get folks to come over and actually, you know, try to be a part of the show. And we're going to have nothing but a good time tomorrow.
We're going to have a real good time.
It's going to be on. I can't wait, man. I'm excited. You know, and everybody here, just want to let you know, if you don't get a chance to run down to Redline Speed Shop on Wednesday nights, we have Armor Coat here available.
Wow. Mark that one down.
Available. Available.
He's thinking about Bill Dobier.
Yeah.
Available Dobier.
Yeah. He ain't going to like me when he comes on the show. He was a great guy, though, man. I actually had a chance to meet him down at Paradise Acres. And we had a lot of cars that come together. Like I said, we were asked to come down for the cancer benefit, and it all sparked off a phone call from the Bottom Feeders Fishing Club. Nick Jones, some guys doing a lot of good things with fishing, and he called and he said, Rooster, man, can you guys get some cars down there? I was like, shoot, I called you, you know, and next thing you know, we had sprint cars and junior dragsters and mod lights and
go-karts,
and I mean, all kinds of people come together. Super street cars, Donovan Action Jackson was down there, and everybody come together kind of like a Racing for a Cure team. And that's something we were talking about, maybe putting together. It doesn't matter what kind of racing car, truck, motorcycle you're into. We want to start going to some of these different events and set up as Racing for a Cure. And, you know, if we can put $1 back into helping children with cancer or somebody locally with cancer, like we're looking at doing with the Backpack Buddies program.
Exactly.
Of, you know, feeding hungry children. And that's what we want to lean towards with this whole Shine Runners Racing thing, to not only promote racing, but to give back to the community and do things for people.
And know? That really is the number one thing of why we started this. So we are pursuing that as hard as we can. But another thing that you had posted earlier on the Shine Runners Racing Radio page, if anybody's got old cars,
yes,
can kind of dress up back towards the 40s, we're going to do an intro / music / just an excuse to get out and cook and drink beer kind of video. Come on out and get a hold of us, because we need some old cars. Now, you said 1940s and above.
Yeah.
Right?
1940 and below.
1940 and below. Cop cars especially.
Yeah. We're looking for an old lanky cop, and we're looking for some bloodhounds.
We got a lanky cop in the studio?
You better be easy, son. You might be leaving in the back of that cop car.
What was funny, he said the other night, he come in here, we got a little mock steel that we made. You know, it hasn't been ran or nothing, but we actually made it up just for the Shine Runners thing. He was like, I think we're going to have to come check the spot out. But, no, we're actually doing some stuff, man. We're trying to – and if you can go out, if you've got that intro, if you can replay that front intro, that we did yesterday, just out having a good time.
Yep.
Stay tuned. You're watching Shine Runners Racing Radio. Hey, y'all happen to see the revenue.
So that's basically just a little headliner we were doing. You know, we want to actually get that stuff going on. Whatever this kind of advice you got is wicked, dude.
This thing right here, man, I don't even have my phone where I can put in it. But this thing is the craziest thing I've ever seen, and I didn't really know how to work it. So I was trying last night at the fireworks show at Baywood to try it. But it's like a camera stabilizer. It does all this gyrating and stuff. I mean, it gyrates more than Michael Jackson or Elvis Presley.
When you give rednecks money, they buy stuff.
No, I was about to say, keep rednecks AJ credit. Away from Best Buy. AJ away from Best Buy.
Yeah. Keep me away from there. My wife hates it. She don't even want me to go near that place.
Well, man, I'm excited for tomorrow. I'm excited for tomorrow evening, the Wayne Gray Memorial Race. Excited for the weekend. Got a lot of cool stuff going on down the Rattlesnake. The Carolina Sprint's coming in. Clary's got their $4,000 to win.
County Line,
got the $4,000 to win. Test and Tune Friday night at Fayetteville Motor Sports Park. So there's racing everywhere around, man. Don't forget the Rock of Hope's going to be kicking off down Saturday night. A lot of good racing going on all over the place. So y'all tune in, check them out. Go to these Facebook pages. Tell them Shine Runners Racing Radio sent you. You know
good
what I mean?
Deal.
Anybody got anything?
Jegs All Stars.
That's right. We've got some local guys. Jeff Longney is actually
in Chicago.
Down. Yeah,
right.
It's Chicago. They're in Chicago right now. Who else was it?
Kevin Reiner.
Mm-hmm. You know, that are down in Chicago right now for the NHRA.
And hopefully, if they're watching, man, they'll post some updates for us too.
Yeah.
And we can see what's going on.
That's Street Stock and Super Stock. Yeah,
we
Super Stock and Stock.
Show.
Okay, cool. So live, what on the NHRA show?
FS2,
FS2. FS1. Okay.
Awesome. Cool. So check that out, man. Be pulling for Mr. Longany. We actually had him on the other day, man, Jeff and them guys. So, you know, I greatly appreciate everybody here tonight. And if there's anything else, anybody got anything else? Shine, girls?
I was going to bring up that Chad Sexton might be a late entry here. He's offered to ride the camel around the track if we can get him on board.
1-900-CHAD-SEXTON.
Yeah.
Have we still got that available?
No, I think we had to move it out. But
well, look at you, Bobby.
You never get to eat. I don't want to hear it.
I appreciate it. Look at Bobby. Come here. Come here, Bobby.
No.
Come here. No, Bobby, come here. Come here just a second. I'm going to make way to get Bobby in here just a second. Hold them over there. Hold them over there so you can hold them babies up.
Don't put them in front of me.
Come over here and sit
there.
Well, I try to let everybody else eat. I mean, I try to be nice.
That's 38 of them right there for you.
38. I'm sure I can put them down. A lot of people have been working in the gym trying to get that sexy body. I've been working at like Strickland's. You know, they got an apple ugly down there for $1.07 that is just off the chain good. But Bobby, we appreciate you, man.
Thank you.
You know, all that you and Tony have done for Shine Runners Racing Radio, and even tonight, I hope things worked out well for you.
It did. Look at the crowd in here.
Yeah.
I'd say probably 95% of them came out to eat with us. Extremely good. Thanking each and every one of you for what you've done.
We had Eastover Fire Department actually come in for the first order and dropped off 50 wings right off the bat. You know, Eric Canizero and them guys over there that are fighting fire for the community and stuff.
Yeah.
We appreciate them. And, you know, you travel all over the place.
Oh, yeah. Getting ready to hit the road again. We got to work out something to get somebody in there to feed you guys while we're gone.
Yeah. So we'll figure that out, man.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
oh, yeah.
We got time.
You know, wings.
Huh? We got time. But, you know, thank you, man, for everything. Like I said, and how did the other week we were talking about going down to Baywood, how Baywood turn out?
Baywood was real good. We had some of the people that's here tonight that was from Baywood. They were excited about seeing us going back again. And, you know, we're excited about going back. But you sort of have to wait on the list. They have a list over there, and we're just waiting on that, waiting for them to call us again.
And you'll go anywhere as long as there's 25 people to serve.
25 or more, we'll roll. Right,
right up in the backyard, front yard.
That's it.
I'm going to just start throwing parties at my house.
Are you? Well, bring the Bud Light and the beer nuts.
We ain't got to worry about AJ talking for the rest of the night. He's gonna have a mouthful of chicken.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So won't you sort of go ahead and wind this on down so you can eat, because I want you to eat before tonight's over.
Let's do that, man. Everybody, anybody else got anything to say tonight here on the show? Want to thank everybody for coming out. It's been a great time racing, Ryan. Hope to see you tomorrow night. The beautiful Shine Girls will be out handing out stickers, all kinds of good stuff. Don't forget, Fayetteville Motor Speedway tomorrow night. The Lucas Oil, the Wayne Gray Memorial coming up this weekend as well. Dublin, the Rattlesnakes got the awesome Carolina Sprints coming down, so make sure you check them out on all the sites and tell them Shine Runner Racing Radio sent you. Y'all have a good one.